Teaching is one of the fastest ways to establish yourself as an authority, as a leader and resource in your niche and industry. Cheryl Plouf, your video strategist, and one of my community members asked me a question. She said, how can I teach and mentor and coach using a slide deck, a presentation, let's say a webinar, and do that on Facebook Live? And I'm going to walk you through the process on how you can do that and some of my tips to make this process seamless. So let's get into it. You're looking at my interface, my Creator Studio interface. I'm getting ready to go live. I'm already in my Facebook page. I've gone to Publishing Tools. I'm in Creator Studio and I'm ready to set things up. And what you're looking at is a screen share of that now. So let me go down to the settings just so that we can be on the same page. That when you scroll down to get started, you will want to choose use camera in this case. Continue to scroll down to the setup section. Choose the camera and the microphone that you want to use, and the start screen share button is right here, but don't press it just yet. Here's the big tip that I want to share with you. When I use, in this case, I am an iOS Mac girl. I like to use Keynote to create my slide deck presentations. If I open up my Keynote deck, there is a navigator bar here over on the left, and I've also got other, you know, things over on the right-hand side. And yes, there are ways that you can, you know, change the view and get rid of the navigator and then move the inspector out of the way and hide that. But what I have found that despite that, if I click, get rid of those things, and I want to make this full screen, I find it challenging to move through the slides when I'm screen sharing, whether I'm using my trackpad or using my mouse. If you've had better luck with this, please let me know in the comments. But for me, one of the things that I like to do is I like to click File and export my Keynote as a PDF. I have had far better luck sharing a PDF than I have the actual Keynote deck itself. So what I've done is I've exported this to my computer as a PDF. And that's what this is. So I'm opening up my PDF, which is my slide deck presentation, and it's full screen, open as a window on my computer right now. Great. Now let's go back to the Google Chrome icon, and we're going to toggle between Google Chrome, which is going to give me access to going live on Facebook, and then toggling between that and the preview icon, which is my PDF. So let's go back to Google Chrome, and I won't click go live just yet, but this is where you would click go live when you're ready. So let's go to start screen share first, and I'll show you that you can share your entire screen. I would say 85% of the time, this is what I use. You can also choose application window. Now I can tell by looking at this that this one on the right hand side is the Keynote. This one is the PDF. So I want to choose PDF, and I can tell that because the Keynote has the navigator and the inspector visible on the screen. I know that this is the PDF. So that's what I want to share. So now I am, and I can see the bar at the bottom that says Facebook is sharing a window. So now I know I'm sharing this window and I'm ready to go live. So I can come back over here, click go live, then toggle back to the preview, and now I can move through and scroll through my slide deck and do the teaching that I want to do. One other quick thing that you may want to think about when you have a PDF like this one is on the left-hand side, when you click on the, I don't know what this little menu is called, but this little, view menu is what it's called. You can choose this to be on continuous scroll, meaning that it will just scroll through and roll through the slides. I personally like to have it on single page, and it is sensitive, but it will bring each of the pages up rather than scrolling through. I think that's a personal preference. but you can choose to share it however you like. So get out there and share your screen, have fun with this, get on Facebook Live, and do the teaching that you're meant to be doing in this world. Be sure to check out these other Facebook-related videos next on my channel.